Thank you. I'm looking forward to hearing the closing statement by White House counsel Pat Cipollone. It is very clear that Adam Schiff has presented the weakest case in our nation's history when it comes to impeachment. As you heard from Jay Sekulow, we heard part of the story from Adam Schiff, who took testimony out of context and didn't provide the fulsome facts. What you heard from the president's defense team were those facts that are important to get across the American public. One, there was widespread concern about corruption in Ukraine. Jay pointed out that it wasn't until September 7th that the high court was finalized in Ukraine to tamp down on that corruption. Number two, there were concerns about Hunter Biden's role on the board of Burisma. We heard that in Ambassador Yovanovitch's testimony during the Obama administration, widespread concerns. Number three, not a single witness testified that they have direct evidence of impeachable offenses, high crimes, misdemeanors, bribery, or treason. So the facts, despite the fact that we are 70 plus days into this, the facts have remained the same in that Ukraine received the aid, in fact, more aid than during the Obama administration in the form of anti-tank missiles javelins, which Jay noted that three of the Democrats opposed. I think it is important, and I supported that increased security assistance. And the second key fact is there was no investigation into the Bidens. So the facts remain the same. The American people understand this. They want to get beyond this very partisan impeachment. And this is a very dangerous precedent that has been set for future Congresses when you have divided government.